Lepinus is part of the Rockwell Group, primarily known for insulation, with 39 production locations across the world, 11,500 people. It offers financial stability and state-of-the-art equipment that we as Lepinus use to produce high quality and high consistency fibers that are being sold across the world for about how many years, Mark?
More than 25 years. We really started at the time that asbestos started to be prohibited in Europe. Mm-hmm. In fact, what happened at that time is that one of our customers, still today a customer by the way, came to us and was looking for an asbestos replacement and needed a high performance, high temperature resistant fiber. And he thought of Rockwell. And so he came to us and asked for a bag of fiber, and that's the way we started.
Okay.
And today, when you look at the market, we are still market leader in selling mineral fibers to the friction material market. We supply all the OE customers, so the friction material producers who make disc brake pads for new vehicles, as well as the aftermarket worldwide.
And of course, to put that in a little bit in perspective, if you look at the global car market today, so passenger cars, we see an annual production of roughly 90 million cars and roughly a car park of 1.2 billion cars.
So we see that China is the biggest automotive market nowadays, and that we see that in the light vehicle sales, car sales, but also in the commercial vehicle sales.
Yeah.
That's the biggest market. There's about 1.4 billion people living there. So they have a huge in internal market, and then we all know that the majority of production products made worldwide is coming from China.
Yeah, I think we can estimate that roughly one third of all cars being manufactured are currently coming from China.
Yeah, yeah. Maybe also what is important in China is of course, it's a huge internal market. What we see in passenger car sales and in what expected passenger car sales in coming years is the fact that the growth in sales of new cars will come from countries in development, under development. Mm-hmm. And China is the first country, India second country, also looking at the number of consumers there, potential consumers there.
Sure.
And also the car density in these countries, it's still quite low. In USA, we are more than 800 cars per 1,000 people. In Europe, I think it's about 500 to 600.
Yeah.
But in China and in even India more, it's much less.
It's still a booming business, right?
It's still a booming business with a lot of potential to grow.
Yeah. And I think growth in the automotive market is one thing, but then again, also the cars are changing. Of course, combustion is changing, going from combustion engines to hybrids, to EVs. Standardization in platforms.
No.
So also there we see change of the car, which has an effect on the brake system, which has an effect on the brake pad, and which even has an effect on us as a raw material supplier, taking that whole chain into account. But then again, a pad is not just a pad. There are of course also regional differences being mentioned as formulation styles, right?
Yeah, sure. If you look at the market nowadays, and of course the friction industry is very conservative, but at the moment two typical brake pads formulation designs are being used. Then we talk about a low steel kind of material, where steel fibers are involved, and an NEO kind of material, non-asbestos organic. Usually it's non-steel. That's also the material where Lepinus fibers are being used. Widely. The typical differences are region-based. Low steel materials are being used in Europe. That's especially to do with the high performance aspects that are required, like for example the German highway. These materials have a very high friction level. They are quite stable, especially at high temperatures, but they also have a disadvantage that they wear a lot. Black wheel dust is an issue. Corrosion plays a role because of the steel wedges inside of the materials, and of course they are quite noisy. In Europe we don't care too much about noise, but that that's becoming more and more important, of course, especially moving into EV, which we talk about later. If we look at the annual type of materials, they are being used in mainly in Asia, but also in North America.
Yeah.
These have the benefit that comfort is very important from that perspective. So noise is much lower, also wear levels are lower, the comfort, so the pedal feeling is much better, but the overall friction level is less. And of course, due to cars that become in heavier weight, friction levels need to be increased, so there is way for improvement.
Yeah. That makes sense.